Beautiful is not used for men, but handsome is used for man's appearance. Ma'am, is error in part 2 or part 4? Okay, let's quickly look at it. So basically, I'm sure you understand the context, right? When basically they're saying when you're describing a man, you don't use the adjective beautiful because beautiful is usually used for women. And if you want to describe a man, the right adjective is handsome. That's what the context is saying. That's the meaning, right? So what can you change? Beautiful is not used for men, correct? But what is used? Handsome is used for not man's appearance, right? Yes, it is the error. Something is funny about the whole thing. Because for as a preposition also is not very right for me, if you ask me. So, I will completely change the context. I'll say the error is in part 4, definitely. And I'll change it saying beautiful is not used for men, but handsome is used to describe men, right? Or for men's appearances, more than one man we're talking about, right? So, use a plural noun number. That's about it. Okay, either ways is fine, but the error is in part 4. Beautiful is not used for men, but handsome is used again for a man's appearance. Structurally, like I said, I would go with, you know, to describe men. For man's appearance as a phrase is incorrect. The error is in part 4. Even if you have to change it, I will say beautiful is not used to describe a man, but handsome is used. And I will not even use the remaining part because it's very redundant. Or I will say, beautiful is not used for men, but handsome is used to describe a man. So, I don't sound redundant in meaning. This is one option. So, these are the various options. Okay. When I first visited Mexicali, I had heard rumors about La Chinese Car, a network of basement tunnels where the city's Chinese immigrants had created their own underground Chinatown. This is an easy one. You can quickly identify if there is an error or not. Undergone, it's a vocabulary error, right? This is an incorrect word here. Doesn't make any sense. It's not, sorry guys, as soon as you read it, you know where the error is because this word is not making sense. If you undergo something means you went through something, but that's not what the context is saying, right? The option, the error is in part D. You change undergone to underground. That makes more sense. When I first visited Mexicali, I'd heard rumors about La Chinese, a network of basement tunnels where, and we're talking about basement. That's your clue word, right? Basement tunnels is your clue word, where the city's Chinese immigrants had created their own underground Chinatown, not undergone. So it's a vocabulary error. It's a wrong word usage. The error is in part D, right? If you don't follow closely, basement tunnels is your clue phrase. Okay, yeah, see, that's what happens. You will have errors pertaining to vocabulary where it's very close, you know, because our brain usually has a tendency to overlook words in between, you know. When we read also, you know how people read fast, the average reading speed or reading fluency is, you know, over 300, 350 words per limit, because our tendency to, when we read, is to look at the first word and the last letter of the word and try and figure out what the word is. That's how we read. So, error part D, this is a vocabulary error, incorrect word in the context. Okay? Like, just like spelling, this also is something that we can overlook easily. Communication IT minister downplayed steps taken by telecom operators to self-regulate services, saying it's the consumers who need to testify if these initiatives were working or not. Okay? Why is where used here instead of are in fourth part of the sentence, even though it is and need is used in third part of the sentence? Okay, good question. But the context as such seems like there is no error, right? In fact, that's not even his question. Ritesh's question is, why are we using where, which is past tense, where here it is, you know, present tense. In fact, this is more to do with subject-verb agreement, right? Consumers, more than one consumer need. So, this is a plural subject, right? And this is fine. So, this is a plural verb. Now, the reason why where is used in the last part is because we're talking about the initiatives that have already been implemented, right? Are you following context? The reason why is used here is because they are yet to testify. They haven't testified. So, they're asking them currently to testify, meaning to affirm or to tell how it was working. So, since the initiatives, I'm just explaining here, since the initiatives were already implemented, they want to know if it worked or not. Right? So, that's why where is correct in the last part. They're talking about something that has already been implemented. So they want to know if it was working or not, if it had worked or not, right? The consumers have not completed testifying, are yet to testify. Or to put it in another context, they have been asked to testify, right? Are you following? So that's why where is correct in the fourth part. Okay, when Albert stayed at the African jungle, he chose to put up with many inconveniences such as wild animals and poisonous insects. Let's look at this. When Albert stayed at the African jungle, this is an easy one. He chose to put up with many inconveniences such as, okay, let's go part by part. Okay, most of you are coming back and saying B, 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 but what's wrong in B? Why is everybody saying B? What is wrong with B? Such as the inconvenience of the example is wild animals and poisonous insects. Okay. He chose to put up with many inconveniences. Huh, what's wrong with put up? To put up with means what? It's a phrasal verb, right? To put up with someone means to bear, right? I mean, put up as a phrasal verb has different meanings. I can't put up with this person anymore. He is very annoying, which means I can't tolerate, I can't bear. So in this context, it's correct only, right? The error is in option A. You're referring to a place, an area, African jungle. So at is not the right preposition. It should be in. When Albert stayed in the African jungle, he chose to put up with many inconveniences such as blah, blah, blah. So the error is in part A, change at to in. Okay. Okay. So the chairman had not taken any decision until he had studied the case thoroughly. Okay. So your question was, ma'am, why can't we put although instead of until? Okay. Let's understand the context first. Pretty simple. There are two actions happening one after the other, right? Two actions taking place one after the other. So until the time he finishes studying the case thoroughly, so that's the first action, right? The first action is had studied the case. So he needs to finish this first and then only he will take a decision. So here, I already know when there are two actions in the past happening one after the other, the first action is in past perfect tense, the second action has to be in simple past tense, right? But if you look at your context, the second action also is in past perfect tense, which is incorrect. So all you need to do is say the chairman did not take any decision. Keep it simple. He did not take any decision and that's why the error is in part one. Now to address your second question, until here only refers to the time. Until the time he finishes studying the case, he did not take any decision. That's what the context is saying. So until is in, it's not incorrect. As per the context, it's still grammatically correct. Until refers to the time that he will finish studying the case. After that time only, he will take the decision. Okay, that's it. If you're asking me, can I use although also, it will give you a completely different meaning, right? So it's like saying, although he had studied the case, he did not take a decision. That's a completely different meaning. That's also correct, meaningfully. But in the context, the error is in part one.